Look, you look down in here and you look to see how much leaf debris is there. Half an inch and less is good. More than that is, you know, going to be harmful.
I mean, I imagine everybody's grass looks like this. I mean, yes, probably a lot worse with the brown and the...
So mine, this is zoysia right here. Mine
this is gorgeous.
Good. Right, but, you know, what you want to do to get the thatch out, you want to get one of these rake with tines out, one of those iron rakes, and just rake it out until you get it down about half an inch. Actually, a half an inch preserves some of the water. So it's just like mulching in your garden. So the next thing you want to do that I do is use a little bit of mill organite and fish emulsion. And I spray that on. That's going to give super quick recovery. You're going to have really beautiful grass after that. It's it makes the soil more healthy. And this is very, you know, easy to put down, drop spreader. It's just sludge from the sewer system, and it's a great fertilizer. You know what I mean?
That's interesting. Okay.
You know, okay. And this is locals, our own local stuff. The next thing you have to do is the crabgrass prevention. This is the window of opportunity right now, is in February.
Right now.
Because a lot of seed, the crabgrass has dropped. You want to go to Ace Hardware. This is the best product right here called High Yield Crabgrass Control. And it's very reasonable price. I shopped around, checked the prices.
What is crabgrass exactly?
It's a grass that you see growing in the middle of the year. It looks kind of bluish. If it's a very fine texture, a lot of weed, a lot of seed heads. And you spread it around your yard when you mow your lawn. The seeds stick to the lawnmower, and then you spread it around.
It's hard to get rid of.
Right, it's hard to get rid of. There's really no known herbicide you can use with St. Augustine. So you spread this out, and it kills the seedlings. So that's the next thing you want to do. So you're going to get rid of the weeds in the middle of the summer by putting crabgrass preventer, invigorate the soil with a little mill organite and fish emulsion. Some of the other things that you want to do is, look for bugs. The bugs that are active right now, and I don't know if you can get a close-up of this. I couldn't find any of these. But these white grubs, you know, they're really active in the soil right now. And
they look like what, like maggots type
thing? Kind of like maggots. That's a good way to put it. That's getting everybody started. Hope you're eating breakfast. You know what I mean? But grubs is a little more. But they look that little white thing. And you can tell if you got them by walking on your grass. You know, if you feel softness in your grass and, you know, you feel pushed up, that's the moles after the grubs. And the grubs are really tasty to the moles. Yeah. So you're going to put an application out. They're active this time.
Now's the time to start.
Right. This preparation is everything. Take advantage of this cooler weather. Get out there and get the grass ready. Raking. And then on the lawnmower, you want to make sure if your grass is coming up a little bit, you've got a lot of winter weeds, you just run the lawnmower over it, because we've been having 68 degrees at around 4 inches, and you should be ready for it to go in next month.
Do you kind of cringe when you see people just hack their lawn?
Oh, yeah. I mean, especially
the mower's too low.
Especially this time of the year, you want to keep it around 4 inches because there is some insulation. Yeah. And if you wanted a little nicer yard, you know, you can get some zoysia.
That's nice. I want to crawl in and sleep on
that
stuff.
Exactly.
For more information about gardening, log on to larrysgarden.com. Give them a call at Larry's.